joining us in the studio to take a look at this. It's a leadership coach, Abiola Salami. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Now, there is some noise about the comments made by Bakare on who should succeed Buhari. But is it so off the mark, considering the instances he gave of other leaders like Nelson Mandela, who brought in, according to him, brought in Thabo Mbeki and Cyril Ramaphosa, who is the current president of that country at this time? Is he so off the mark to ask President Buhari to pick a successor?
I would say that if any Nigerian is saying to the president of the country, saying that be interested in who your successor would be, I think that is not out of place, because there is no success in leadership without a successor. However, being interested is different from picking someone, naming the person as a successor. We are in a democracy, you see. And one of the things I believe in is on emotional intelligence. We talked about empathy, seeking to understand people, seeking first to understand before you are understood. If we understand that our process is a democratic process, it means there are things that needed to be done to ensure that we are really in a democracy and not dictatorship. So the president is right to have said that, yes, I am interested in who my successor would be, and I expect the president to build on the gains of my administration. But for anybody to think that the way to go is to handpick someone and start to push, that won't be effective. That won't be democracy.
What is your understanding of what Tunde Bakare meant? He is a man that has been in the public light. He, at some point, said he's going to be President Buhari's successor. And just recently, we understand he went to see the president. Are you understanding it in the light that he is suggesting that the president should be interested, which the president has said he would be, or is he, like some persons are alluding, asking that the president should pick him? If you take into cognizance what he said earlier, that he is going to be the next president of Nigeria.
Fantastic. As a leadership coach, I am always principle-centered and not people-centered, as it were, right? And by principle-centered, I'm asking the question, what should a leader do? What the leader should do is to be interested in whoever will succeed that leader. I won't interpret the statement by Pastor Tunde Bakare to mean that he's saying he should choose Pastor Tunde, that the president should choose Pastor Tunde Bakare as a successor. That is not what I heard. I will understand it as a Nigerian who is concerned, just like I am a Nigerian, just like you are a Nigerian who is concerned saying to the president that for continuity's sake, be interested in whoever will emerge as your successor. If Pastor Tunde Bakare is saying that select me as your successor, that is not right. But if what is saying, based on my understanding, is as a Nigerian who is saying that, Mr. President, you need to pay attention to whoever will succeed you so that there is continuity. And there's history in our country of an administration coming in, and when a new administration comes in, forget the project, forget the principles, forget whatever the previous leader is doing, and there's no continuity, which is one of the biggest problems for our country. So whether it is within the same party or within different parties, there should be continuity. So a current president, a sitting president, should be concerned about whoever emerges as the president. And while the sitting president is concerned, the decision of who becomes president after him is not his. The decision of who becomes president after him should be the people who will vote for whichever candidate they've chosen and based on the result of
the election. Isn't it contradictory when you say that the president should have interest in who becomes president first? There has to be an antecedent that the president will see that will encourage him to say that this person will not throw away what I have done in the past. And the president has said before now as well that I'm not going to run for office. I will not handpick who will become the president. He is also on record as saying that even though he's off being a candidate for the election, he will take interest and participate as much as he can to ensure that the electoral process is fair and clear. Remember, we do have slight history. Obasanjo, at some point, we know he had a hand in who came in the next time. We have the case of Goodluck. Some said he was picked and all of that. The people voted at the end of the day, but some background work was done. Do you have confidence that this will not play out in this instance, in spite of what has been said? Because if you want your legacy to be maintained, you have to take a stronger stake on what comes afterwards.
Yes, you need to be concerned about what comes afterwards. So, to the limit of the president's power, should be who are the candidates for primaries. Based on all those people that are showing up, that are interested, who do we think best fit? And based on the conversation within the party, they hold their primaries, they decide on whoever the candidate they want to select to be. Once party A decides that this is our candidate, party B should also decide whoever is their candidate. And then let everybody come for elections and whoever wins that election. Because you see, when it comes to politics, we tend to have general statements and people also develop opinions that are just mouth things people say, that are just hearsay, that we don't actually have facts, as it were. So saying that a particular president chose someone and then there's some background work that was done, if it is in the public light, if it is a proof, if we have proof, if somebody was arrested for doing what the president is not supposed to do, if there are things like that, then we can say there is an antecedent. But when it is what somebody says, or these days of social media, somebody took a picture somewhere, that was a time ago that a picture was going all around and they say, oh, no, that picture didn't happen, that thing didn't happen in Nigeria, it happened in some other country, because we can't really verify where things, some of these things are happening.
Well, now I'll begin to say that maybe you are also being a sentimental when you talk about the issue of, you know, somebody cannot pick a successor. Even as at the elections of 2019, there were conversation and, you know, manipulations ahead of 2023 elections. We already know that there are moves behind the scene for this to happen. What is your take, basically, on secession in Nigeria? We have the case in Edo State, the conflict between APC leader and the incumbent governor. We also know that there are moves. So, secession in Nigeria, basically, in politics.
Okay.
Do you think that, you know, just saying it does not exist mean it does not exist?
Succession exists whether you do anything about it or not. Somebody will always come in after somebody. But what we should put our minds to is what should be the guiding principles for succession. And that is what this conversation should be about, so that we can learn, so that also for those in politics can learn how to practice. And when we see people not doing the right thing, we can hold them accountable. But if we just engage in choosing the side that we belong, what we think should be and what shouldn't be, based on what we are gaining personally, the country will not move forward. So what should be the guiding principles
exactly
for succession?
Saying,
no. Number one is competence. So whoever it is that will come in after us in this political party, the person should have competence. And by competence, I'm not talking about whatever they use the media to do to paint anybody in the light of being competent, the track record of the individual. What has the person handled before? And the person doesn't need to even be in politics before. The person just to be someone who shows responsibility. The person should be someone who is visionary in the person's approach, whether it's in business, whether it's in public sector. In the way the person has led a group of people before, it may be 10 people the person led, it may be 1,000 people the person led. It doesn't really matter. What we are looking for are the principles. So number one, is this person competent enough? Two, is the person visionary? Vision is the ability to just see tomorrow and commit today to birthing something better for tomorrow.
Do you see people like that in this country?
There are people like that in this country.
Are they willing to bring themselves forward? Because that's another thing.
The number of people like that in this country. Are they willing to bring themselves forward? The number of people who are willing to bring themselves forward. And we shouldn't think that there's a dearth of competence in our country. Even in the political parties, well-structured parties, there are people with competence and people who are visionary. And we shouldn't think that there is scarcity of any of those. We have them in excess. We have competent people in excess. We have people who are doing great jobs within the country. We are also, from time to time, exporting competence out to other countries to help them to develop. So these are the metrics that we want to check. Is this individual visionary? Is this person, does this person listen to people? Does the person empathize? Is this person competent on the job? Is this person courageous to make certain decisions? Is this person selfless or selfish? These are the metrics that you want to use to check. So when people are throwing in their cards to say that I want to be voted for within the primaries, you want to check some of these traits of the individual, that the behavior that the individual has consistently exhibited over a period of time, not for a short period of time, and not propaganda, not people whitewashing the the person's behavior, but there are substantial proofs of this person's competence.
Antecedent is a must if we must get good leaders. But
yes.
You will agree, Nigerians, we have a problem with remembering when it's gone. But thank you very much for your thoughts on the news.
Thank you for having me.